there's a lot of inaccurate information going around about the topic of SIM card cloning. Even here on YouTube, there's a number of videos that don't give completely accurate information. I also found this mention on Wikipedia on this page about phone cloning, and the section about SIM card cloning is actually kind of wrong. So by SIM card cloning, I mean copying a SIM so that you then have a second SIM card that can also make and receive calls and text messages using exactly the same phone number as the original SIM card. In theory, you would also be able to use that to listen in and decrypt phone calls made using the original SIM card. And to demonstrate how it was once possible, I'm going to show in this video exactly how it was done. To do this, I'm going to use this SIM card to USB adapter. These adapters are very cheap and easy to find. And I'm going to be attempting to copy this very old 2G SIM card. To copy a SIM card, you need to read two numbers out of the card. The first number is the IMSI, or International Mobile Subscriber Identity Number. This number is actually really easy to get. In fact, with most Android phones, if you download a SIM card app, it will simply show you this number. But to copy a SIM, you need one other number from the card. And this is the KI, or key number. I've also got my Windows XP laptop here, but the software I'm using here should be able to run on just about any modern version of Windows. The software I'm using is called WaronScan, a neat little program that enables me to talk to a SIM card using very low-level commands. I'm now going to use the key extraction function of this software, and I'm going to have to leave this running for quite a while. And that's because it's not possible to read the key number directly, and it's the job of a SIM card to keep this number secret at all times. The key number is really important because it's how your carrier authenticates your phone on the network. It does this by picking a random number and then doing a calculation with your key number, which the network also knows and keeps secret. Then it sends this random number to your phone. Your phone then asks the SIM card to also do this same calculation using your secret key number and gets a result. If the result from your SIM card and the result that the network itself calculated match, then the phone call or message has now been authenticated and the network now sets up the communication. Then in 1998, cryptographic researchers found by examining the GSM standards, they were able to work out how the calculation was being done. But to copy a SIM card, you would still need to know what the key number is. The researchers found that the algorithm also had some flaws. They found if you collect enough responses, then you can eventually work out what the key number is. And that's what's happening here. This software is asking the SIM card to run the authentication over and over again, thousands of times. This poor SIM card normally at most does a few dozen of these per day, but today it's being hammered. And then suddenly it seems to have stopped. Everything seems to have locked up at 5,849 calculations. I've tried starting the process again, and it seems this SIM card is now dead. It obviously couldn't take the heat, and I seem to have killed it. I've had a look through some of the other SIM cards I've got, and I found this Optus SIM that looks fairly old. I think this is a good candidate to try this process again. The first thing I've noticed about this Optus SIM compared to the Telstra SIM is that the authentication rates, it seems to be running a lot slower, which means it's going to take a lot longer to get enough responses to work out the key number. But it's also a good sign that this should actually be an older SIM card. I'll let this run, and I'll see if it can get the KI number for this SIM card. If this is an older SIM card, then eventually we will get the key number.
You had something to hide. Should have hidden it, shouldn't you? Now you're not satisfied with what you're being put through. Thank you.
when this calculation was originally designed, it was kept secret, and not many people had seen how it works. And so there weren't enough people to spot the flaws. When the algorithm eventually became known to many, and people started to see the flaws in the calculation, the part that was meant to be secret, the key number, was compromised. Okay, that took about 40 minutes or so, but after 16,616 calculations, the key number has been found. Combined with the IMSI means I can now clone this SIM card. And in the previous video, I made a dummy SIM card that ran entirely emulated on a computer. If I now input the IMSI and the key number into that software, I can now emulate the SIM card and do everything the original SIM card can do. But for this video, I want to make a real copy of this SIM card, which means getting a blank SIM card and writing a copy of the original into it. I have here a SIM Max card by STK. It comes with a couple of software programs. One is the SIM Editor program, and this is just a basic editor that can edit phone numbers and text messages that are stored on the SIM card. The other program this comes with is the SIM Scanner software, and this will do the same thing as Waron Scan. It will scan a SIM card and get the IMSI and the KI, but it will also give the option of writing that to the SIM Max, making a full clone. Now, unfortunately, I can't just enter the KI into this software and write to the SIM Max directly because it doesn't give me that option. So I'm going to run the recalculation process all over again on this poor SIM card. This software has a couple of different options. One is the A3 limit option, where you can set the maximum number of authentications on the SIM card to below 65,000. There's also an option for a strong KI number. These appear to be options to deal with early attempts to thwart cloning. Some SIM cards were designed to stop working when you did more than 65,000 calculations, and strong KI may have been an attempt to pick strong key numbers that were hard to crack. And then finally, after 29,207 calculations, this software has got the key number. This took almost twice as long as Waron Scan. Waron Scan probably uses a more efficient way of working out what the key number is. But it's done now, and I have everything I need to make a copy of the SIM. Replacing the Optus SIM with the SIM Max card, I can now go to the Write SIM option. This particular SIM Max card has the option to hold the profiles of 12 different SIM cards and their key numbers. But I'm only wanting to copy one SIM, so I'll write the profile into the first slot. I now have a clone SIM card, two exact copies of the same SIM. Now, I'm not going to be able to test these on a network because the 2G networks around here all shut down years ago, but I still want to be certain that I have an exact copy of this SIM card. So I'm switching back to Waron Scan, which has an option to test the authentication using the Run GSM algorithm command. With this command, I'll also have to send the random number to be used in the calculation. This is an extra 16 bytes. And then I get the 12-byte response, plus 9000 at the end, which is just SIM card speak for end of response. With that done, I'm now going to run the exact same calculation on the clone SIM card, which means entering the exact same random number all over again. And then getting the response, I can see I've got an exact match from the first SIM card. I've now confirmed that I've got a cloned SIM card. So what stops this happening today with modern SIM cards? Well, these flaws were originally exposed in 1998 in the COMP128 algorithm. And in response, new algorithms were developed, COMP128 version 2 and COMP128 version 3. Both of these algorithms have been pretty well known for the past 20 years, and in that time, no one has found any flaws to reverse the process and work out what the key numbers are inside SIM cards. That means it's no longer possible to clone a SIM card unless you can find another way to get your key number. Now, there are a couple of other places that your key number is stored. One, of course, is your network provider. But the other place you can get key numbers from is from SIM card manufacturers themselves. And it turns out the security of SIM card manufacturers is fairly lax compared to network providers. For example, when a network provider orders, say, 500,000 SIM cards, the card manufacturer will just email them the key numbers for all those cards, in plain text, unencrypted, and easy to intercept. And we know this because that's exactly how many government security agencies get access to key numbers. Security agencies for years have been hacking into card manufacturers to gather up all the key numbers that they can. At this point, they pretty much know everyone's key numbers from every SIM card in the world. And that's billions of key numbers. So you can be pretty certain they've got your key number, but they're not interested in cloning your SIM card. They just want to listen in if they need to. That's the truth about SIM card cloning. Oh yeah, that Wikipedia article that got it all wrong. The first paragraph talks about putting a device between the SIM card and the phone to capture the responses of the calculation. Unfortunately, as I've demonstrated here, you need tens of thousands of responses to work out the key number. And there's no way you're going to be able to get enough just by capturing everything between the phone and the SIM card. And the second paragraph talks about an adapter. That's actually not related to SIM card cloning and not a relevant piece of information in this article. I'm sure this article will get updated soon, so if you're watching this video in the future, that may have changed. And that's really it for now. We've reached the end of the video. I hope you've enjoyed this. It's been a lot of fun looking at all of this. I'd like to thank my patrons who continue to support and everyone who watches and likes and shares and comments. Thank you. You're really helping this channel to continue. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.
Now you're standing there in sun's eyes. You better be learning your lesson well. What you have to hide, and tell what you have to tell. You'll see your problems multiply if you continually decide to favor.